Hello students, myself Mangala, and in this entire year I will be teaching computer science for you. So let us begin with the first chapter, that is typical configuration of computer system. First we shall see what is computer. Computer is basically includes a series of electronic and electrical circuits together to form a single unit to perform the required operation. So computer is a combination of electric and electronic circuit to perform the required operations which is required by the user. So next is the terms used in computer system. There are four terms used in computer system. Those are hardware, software, data and users. We shall see one by one. First is hardware. Hardware is nothing but it is a physical device which is used in computer systems. For example, keyboard, monitor, printer, processor and motherboard. Next is software. Software is a set of instructions or the programs which will ask the computer to perform some tasks or how it will be performed. So next is data. Data is the values or the raw facts which is given to the computer as a input. Next is user. Users are the people who write the computer program or people who interact with the computer. So the four terms used in the computer are hardware, software, data and users. Next topic is block diagram of computer. The computer is designed by using four units. Those are input unit, sender processing unit, memory unit and output unit. We will see one by one. First is input unit. In order to perform tasks or any operation, computer must receive some instructions. These instructions will be received by the input unit. For example, in your laptop or personal computer, you may have n number of audio files or video files. By looking on that, can they, does that video or audio play? No, right? So we are giving some instruction to mouse or keyboard. By that time, the video or audio file will play. Like that, it will link the, that input unit will link the external world with the computer system, and the input which is received by the computer will be converted to binary form, that is 0 or 1, so that computer can perform some tasks on that instruction. Next is CPU, that is control processing unit. Control processing unit is a main part of the computer. It is also called as the brain of the computer. It includes two more units, that is control unit and arithmetic and logical unit. Let's see what control unit will do. It will control the sequence of executions of the instruction. Whatever the instruction we are giving to the input unit, that instruction will be controlled by the control unit. Also, this control unit will control and coordinate all the functions of the units like input unit, memory unit and output unit. Next is ALU. ALU is nothing but arithmetic and logical unit. It will do some arithmetic and logical operations on inputs which are given by the input units. Next, this CPU is also contains some registers which are temporarily holding the data or the instructions which are from the input unit. Next is memory unit, is also called as storage unit. So there are two types of memory which is associated with the memory unit. First one is primary memory, second one is secondary memory. So primary memory, also called as main memory of the computer. Primary memory, which is also called as main memory of the computer. contains RAM and ROM. RAM is nothing but random access memory, which is volatile memory, which temporarily stores the files which you are working on. Next one is random, deep working memory, which will permanently contains ROM file and permanently stores the files or the instruction for your computer. So the primary memory or the main memory, which will stores the data, instruction, intermediate results and output before which is given to the or sent to the output unit. Next is secondary memory, which is also called as external memory, which will permanently stores the files and data. For example, for the storage, some secondary memory is a magnetic disk, optical disk, magnetic tapes, and flash drives. So next is output unit. Output unit is used to give the output to the user or to print the output result. Output will be in the form of text, sound, image or document. So the computer will receive the output in the monitor, and the output unit will send the output to the printer to print the output, and output unit will send the output to the sound output to the speaker and letter. So this is about the ROM diagram of computer, which currently contains four units, input unit, control processing unit, memory unit, and output unit, which you have studied in your previous classes. Next, we will see about the main concept of the chapter. The first topic of this chapter is motherboard. So the computer is built up in the motherboard. The motherboard is very important part of the computer system. For example, the heart is a main part of the human body. In the similar way, the motherboard is the main part of computer system. So let's see the definition of the motherboard. The motherboard is a printed circuit board used to connect all the system components like CPU, RAM, graphic cards, etc. So the motherboard is the printed circuit board which is used to connect the system components like central processing unit, random access memory, graphic cards, etc. So what is PCB, that is printed circuit board? It is the electrical, in this PCB, electrical components are electrically connected. For example, if you see in the switchboard, inside the switchboard, we will see different wires, and these different wires are internally connected or electrically connected. So that is called the PCB. So next we will see characteristics of the motherboard. The motherboard is characterized by form factor, chipset, and processor socket. First, we will see form factor. The form factor is the specification of the motherboard. The form factor is the specification of the motherboard. The form factor refers to dimension, geometry, power supply used, and number of ports used, and what type of electrical requirements needed. This will be come under form factor. And then, now motherboard, yaw form alide, yedella power supply use maadidare, number of ports eshtu use maadidare, matte adha geometry andre shape adu hegide, adanna navu form factor alli nodabodu. Next is the chipset. The function of chipset is to coordinate the data transfer between the various components of the computer. For example, like data transfer from input unit to memory unit, or like memory unit to output unit, that way. So next is processor socket. What is processor socket? It is a place where the CPU is connected. Athina munche socket andre eno? It is an endpoint communication between two devices. For example, in a switchboard, you get to see one socket at the ಆ ಸಾಕೆಟ್ಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಚಾರ್ಜರ್ ಅಥವಾ ಈ ಐರನ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಇರೋದು ಅದನ್ನು ಅದನ್ನು ಪ್ಲಗ್ ಇನ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮೇನ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಡಿವೈಸ್ಗೆ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಸಾಕೆಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಎಂಡ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಶನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಅ ಟು ಡಿವೈಸಸ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಅ ಮದರ್ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸರ್ ಸಾಕೆಟ್ ವೇರ್ ದ ಸಿಪಿಯು ಈಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು motherboard. So next topic is types of motherboard. Basically there are four types of motherboard depending upon the processor that has been used. First one is XT motherboard, second one is AT motherboard, third one is baby AT motherboard, and last one is ATX motherboard. So four types of motherboards are XT motherboard, AT motherboard, baby AT motherboard, and ATX motherboard. Let's see one by one.
Ready.
So the types of motherboard, the first type is XT motherboard. First we see what is the full form of this XT. XT stands for Extended Technology. Extended Technology motherboard. These are the motherboard which are used in the earlier days. So, and this motherboard which contains some old model processor sockets, which are first one is LIF sockets, that is low insertion force socket. Second one is RAM slots EIL, which means RAM slot EIL means dual inline memory modules. Third one is ISK slots, that means industry standards architecture slots. And last one, it contains 12 pin power connectors. So this XT motherboard stands for Extended Technology motherboard, and it was used in the earlier days. And this contains some old model processor socket, that is LIF sockets, RAM slot EIL, ISA slots, and it also contains 12 pin power connectors. And second one is AT motherboard. Second type of motherboard is AT motherboard. This AT stands for Advanced Technology motherboard, and this contains some of the components like PGA socket, that means pin grid array socket. Next one is SDRAM slots. SDRAM means synchronous dynamic random access memory slots. Then this AT motherboard which contains 20 pin power connector PCI slots. Also this contains ISA slot, that is industry standard architecture slots. I repeat, this AT motherboard stands for Advanced Technology motherboard, and it contains some of the components like PGA socket, SDRAM socket, 20 pin power connector PCI slots, and ISA slots. This type of AT motherboard was used in earlier personal computers. So the next type is baby AT motherboard. Baby AT motherboard, it is a combination of AT and XT motherboard. It is a combination of Advanced Technology motherboard as well as the Extended Technology motherboard. Both combined to form a baby AT motherboard. So the slot type used here is processor socket and PGA processor sockets. Next, SDRAM slots and DDR RAM slots. DDR RAM means double data rate, RAM slots, and PCI slots, also ISA slots. Next, 12-pin power connector ports and 20-pin power connector ports. Whatever the components used in AT and ST motherboard are present in baby AT motherboard. So, the baby AT motherboard is the combination of AT and ST motherboard. That is advanced technology motherboard and extended technology motherboard. So, the last one is ATX motherboard. It stands for Advanced Technology Extended Motherboard. ATX motherboard stands for Advanced Technology Extended Motherboard. So, the latest motherboard all are called as ATX motherboard. So, nowadays we are going to see ATX motherboard. Let's see, and which is designed by ATX form factor. ATX motherboard is designed by ATX form factor. Some of the components are MPGA processor socket, DDR RAM slots, AGP slots, SATA connectors, and 20-pin and 24-pin ATX power connector and ports. Here they use 20-pin and 24-pin ATX power connector and ports. So, there are four types of motherboard. First one is XT motherboard, that is Extended Technology Motherboard. Second one is AT motherboard, Advanced Technology Motherboard. Third one is Baby AT motherboard, which is the combination of both the XT and AT motherboard. And last